Welcome to another fresh edition of Nigerian Movies Today. This is the program that brings you so much about the Nigerian movie industry with lots of entertainment. As the name is here, it's a journey of movies, exclusives with Nollywood celebrities, Nigerians in the diaspora, and lots more. I am Adetike Akinpelu. A good movie is always refreshing and relays lots of experience. Here's our movie of the week.
On movie of the week is It Happened to Me. The short film is written and produced by late veteran filmmaker Amaka Igwe in conjunction with the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO. The film is directed by renowned writer cum director Chris Ihidero. The film is based on real-life story of Dickey, a 23-year-old apprentice trader based in Abuja, the leading light amongst the youth of his community. His longtime girlfriend Sochima and her younger sister Iberi died within 6 months interval, and the community is convinced that deaths and others are due to Ogbanje. However, Dike's best friend, Kene, a third-year student of laboratory science at the State University, is curious, believing Ogbanje had nothing to do with the deaths.
Why are you disturbing me at quiet time? Everyone and my guys in the morning. I just look at us. What? Again, get this out of Chukamudi here. It's Gumiya and
answer me.
Again, I trust you. I like Romeo. I don't like it. I can hear my fan. Why did you?
I've been asking this stupid question since we ran this village. There is a thrill of death to Sivanus and his ex-girlfriend and their boyfriends.
Again, all the this medical laboratory in Ago, the music if you see any book you doctor B. Okay?
It's a good image to do because it will help save your life.
Choice. Don't touch me. I cannot. My Lolo is dead.
Let me let her rest in peace.
The Lolo is dead, true.
But we should be concerned about you and what you can do. You should talk about your life
and not your dead Lolo.
After all, she died of AIDS.
The movie was shot in Humada community of Udi local government area in Enugu State, where Amaka Igwe's family hails from. The film was premiered at UNESCO headquarters in Paris in November 2013, and it's now premiered online in commemoration of Amaka Igwe's first year anniversary. The film features upcoming acts like Tochukwu Okafor, Desmond Onuwa, Jane Obi, and Chidima Igwani.
Next is where you get to feel or bond with your movie role model. Today in the house, we have one of Nollywood's finest to share his wealth of experience with us. Let's meet, greet, and make welcome Emeka Ike.
On our exclusive guest this week is one of Nollywood's finest who has carved a niche for himself in the Nigerian motion pictures industry, Emeka Thirdsman Ike, popularly called Emeka Ike. Born and bred in Lagos State, Nigeria, he is a native of Ehime Mbano, Imo State. Emeka attended Ansarudin Primary School, Isolo, and Ejibu Community High School in Lagos. He had his A-level at Igbobi College, Fadeyi, and his National Diploma and Higher National Diploma in Mechanical Engineering from Yaba College of Technology, also in Lagos. Emeka Ike's burning passion for acting got him into a popular TV series, Fortune. He got his first stint in the Nigerian motion pictures industry in the movie Deadly Affairs in 1994. He has featured in over 100 movies, some of which includes And the Name of Love, Passion, Together as One, Heart Attack, Classic Love, and a host of others. Emeka Ike, the Golda Ultimate Celebrity Standing, is a title holder as the Ezekwesili Ogbunike of Ogbunike Kingdom, Anambra State. He is the founder of a youth academy affiliated to National Film and TV Institute, Ghana, and the acclaimed winner of the Nigerian Actors Guild elections as ruled by the courts. Emeka is married with 4 children, 3 boys and a girl.
And joining me for the exclusive guest, Connor, is a prolific actor who I have known for a really long time. He says he's old, that shows I'm young. I've actually seen him do so many beautiful things, and he's a prolific actor, I must say. He's known for interpreting various roles in ways that makes the story feel real. Please join me in welcoming Emeka Ike. I hope I pronounced your name well.
Very well, Tuka.
Okay. Hi. It's so good to have you here.
Good day. Pleasure. Same here.
Yeah, I feel like one of my checklists has actually been met. Meet Emeka Ike. Check, I met you.
Thank
okay,
God.
So beyond knowing you to be an actor, who is Emeka Ike? Can we meet you, please?
Emeka Ike is a young Nigerian, you know, hardworking young man who have tried several businesses. I trained as an engineer, Mecha Engine, Yaba Tech, and I tried working, it wasn't easy, and I got myself into movie making, and I'm God-fearing. You don't say it, but people call me, go to my Godo gate and ask the gatesman, what do they call me? They call me the first son of Jesus.
Mm.
And I think it's because of the life I live out there. So I love God, I love humanity, I do what I have to do to serve the mankind, I mean, so. As I make a humble, simple, but most controversial, and that's the press. Because of my stand in life,
I get that. Mm-hmm. Okay, but before we talk about that, we've actually not been seeing you lately in movies. What has been the cause of this?
Because I feel we were wasting the steam. I mean, I felt the steam was not well managed. Now we have an industry that we claim that has given the country 8% or 1.45% GDP rise. By now, Nollywood should have an office space as big as NTA. True or false?
True, I agree.
Now, I want to tell you, Nollywood has a 2-bedroom apartment as an office. Now, I work and I don't get paid. No actor is being paid in Nollywood right now. The structures we used to know had collapsed. Idimota is no more known. You don't hear Idimota anymore, do you?
Mm-mm.
You don't hear Bimpe Jolene anymore, do you?
Mm-mm.
You don't hear about Pound Road, Abba. Those were the days that movie making was charismatic. You see, actors were working. We're heading somewhere. But today, we don't really know where we're headed.
Mm.
Yes, my brother Desmond Elliott has done a good movie. Iniedo has made a good movie. Mami Song has made a good movie. Good. But that's not the quantity of movie Nollywood used to churn out in months, per year. Nollywood had achieved a place of quality. In the world, we're known, okay, as in Nollywood, as of quantity, not quality. We deserve to have quality base. And we're heading towards our quality terrain when we're nipped off. I tell you, Nollywood is nipped off. What you see today are movie makers trying to make movies in their own personal enterprise, in their own single ways, taking their risk. All is their insurance, nobody cares. You don't see any concise effort to have a production team anymore. What you have are individuals. Few individuals making good movies. I made 7 to 12 in my time, if you remember. 7 to 12 in those days, we used helicopters, we went to shoot in Bauchi, where you have Boko Haram today. We went to just to make good movies. These were quality movies. So it's not like we're new to making quality movies. But right now, Nollywood has been hijacked. Now, you don't see Omotola on movie making anymore, right?
Yeah,
you don't see Ramsey in any of the number. Maybe once in a while, you see him with AY in one movie overseas. You don't see Genevieve. You don't see Jamaica. You don't see us anymore.
Why is that?
There's a problem. Now, the people of Nigeria don't know what the issue is. My colleagues were a little bit relaxed, enjoying the heroism, the stardom, and then the love for the job when looking at the structural existence of Nollywood. So structurally, Nollywood was nosediving. Structurally, people were doing business with Nollywood. That was our business. And those businesses has turned out to take over the real Nollywood. So we are pulling the wrong cats right now. The real cat of Nollywood has been abandoned. So the cats were pulling, making noise, whoa, whoa, whoa. People using South African accents to make movies lately. I'm like, what's going on? Do we need accent to tell who we are? Everybody see on TV today is coming, oh, Dar, I'm seeing Dar. I'm like, hello, are we losing something here? So I looked at this whole thing and I felt Nollywood actually needs a redrive.
Okay, so would you say that is money that has actually been the problem for not being able to pull and churn out quality movies?
Structure.
Okay.
You see, when you when you're trying to make this building and you falter or you fail at the foundation level, the building is a mirage. Nollywood's first step was a mirage, was faulty. When we went to register like Actors Guild of Nigeria per se, let's say the talent is the highest figure. If you say in entertainment, the talent is number one. I didn't do theater, but I know that is. So let's say when I say Nollywood, I mean Actors Guild. But I know because it should represent a part of Nollywood. Now, Actors Guild was registered not to favor the Nigerian people, not to favor you. There are people who claim that guild to be their personal property.
Okay, so just hold that thought. We're going to get back to that. So talking about Actors Guild of Nigeria, now there has been a thing because we know that Ibn Abo Fibarisima, I hope I pronounced that well.
Yes.
Used to be the president. And the funniest thing is when I still checked online, I still see her as the president. But I know that the court says you won that election and you are the president. So what's going on? I mean, is it now your tenure or is still ours? Because I don't get, and I'm sure people need to clarify.
We have a sect of desperate people right here. Desperate individuals, they defy the rule of law. We've gotten judgment on them 2 times. This is the second judgment we're getting on Ibn Abo and our group. They don't respect the rule of law. They want you to come violently. So they can say, oh, come on, he's fighting with thugs. But we keep applying the rule of law. Because the rule of law is the only application. Like you apply your apps. That's the only application you can apply in democratic dispensation. So we keep telling them what needs to be done. Competently, I mean, a court of competent jurisdiction has looked at some papers and has seen that you, Ibn Abo, and the board of trustees that put you there, you lack locus standi, meaning you don't have a basis to be where you are.
Okay, Mekai, I want to ask you this. So if Ibn Abo and the board of directors or the so-called people you
board of trustees,
yeah, do not back off. What are you going to do? Keep going to the court to get more papers and to prove that you are the elect president of AGN? Or what are you going
to
do?
This is not about me trying to assert my authority as the AGN president. We are here as agents of change. We keep doing what we know to do right. Like we know we need to serve them from 48. And we have served them. Mm-hmm. Very soon we'll serve them from 49. And they will have the law to run around with. They're already running away. They're already running Hector Skeeter. They're putting wrong images on the internet. We're having peace talk with Emeka, blah, blah. That's not what we're all about. We need to correct it, correct the industry from the basics, from the grassroots. If you're not mandated, if you don't have a mandate to be an administrator, you will not be concerned with so many things around the institution.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't have the mandate of the people. The so-called Board of Trustees lack that mandate.
Okay, so when this frenzy gets over with, what exactly are you going to put in place? Since you've been talking about the structure and all that, so what are you going to put in place once this gets over?
Yeah, already we have, everybody's already on board right now. Most of Ibinabos, ESCOs, we opened the door to everybody to come in and let's build a new industry. We need to keep having congresses. Every association can only survive when you have association meetings.
Hmm.
Then you can determine the things you want for the change you desire. Now, I want to tell you we've never had any Congress all that while you've been hearing these old cases.
Hmm.
So how do you get up people, how do you get to see people appearing on programs, taking money on behalf of the guild? Where does all this money go to? So we are thinking that, we believe that, by the virtue of what the guild has achieved for Nigeria, we deserve a better place in life. We deserve to come as a Congress, ask ourselves questions, then profile a way forward. And one of it is building an AGN city.
Mm.
We are big enough to have NTA compound as our office in Lagos and all over the 36 states of the nation. And that's the only way we can empower the young people out there who has been ignited by the things we do.
I want to act too. Okay.
You see, you are stranded. If this is not corrected, you're stranded. Nobody corrects anything because there is no mandated administration.
Mm.
What you have are a group of people that did lord themselves over the industry, believing nobody would challenge them. Nobody can remove the Board of Trustees. Board of Trustees, go to CAC, they will tell you, is a lifetime Board of Trustees. Lies. And we are in an industry that has a huge ignorance base.
Hmm.
So much stardom, so much ignorance. So what they say now, they say the Board of Trustees say. That's what we keep hearing even among the very spectacular stars you see. Nobody has taken the constitution to go and flip. Are they right or wrong?
Mm.
I flipped. My team flipped. And we discovered they have a 10-year tenure. And the 10-year elapsed 2008. Mm. So since 2008 till now, what have they been doing? And that's the question we're asking in court. That's the questions we're getting all these answers for. That's the question for which they were dissolved by a federal high court under Honorable Justice Soho. They looked at the whole thing. You don't deserve to be here. So you're dissolved. Ibn Abo, your election was contemptuous. I, Justice Soho, told Emeka Ike, do not conduct election. I, Justice Soho, told Segun Arinze, do not conduct elections until this case are properly determined. Why is there an Ibn Abo out there today? Now, that shows impunity. That shows disrespect for the rule of law. That shows God for that reason. Mm-hmm. That shows I don't care. He can go to hell. Now, we can't drive democracy like tyranny, like autocracy. In the days of the military rule, well, she has a godfather. You won't see anything else. Gunmen will come around. But these days, even if there are gunmen around, we know the law is our last hope.
Mm.
We'll try to apply it.
Okay, Mekaike, thank you. I understand that there's so much to talk about, but the time would not just permit. But really, I need to ask this question. Do you think that Nollywood is telling our stories the way it should be? I mean, the filmmakers, are they telling our stories the way it should be?
No, Ma, we used to tell our stories the way it used to be, before now. And that's why all over the world, when you travel to America, to Russia, to Ghana, people are saying, Igwe, Igwe. You know, they are beginning to pick parts of our culture. And I mean, movie making is situated around a culture. It's cultural. The Indians will make movies according to their cultural benefits. The Americans will make movies according to their motherfucking mother, whatever.
yeah.
You know, I'm Nigerian. We make our movies in our Nigerian
way.
Cultural ways. And that's what the world wants to see. But when Nigerians begin to sound like Americans, thinking that is a hype, that's ignorance. Now, our movies will not get into Oscar because we're not making our movies in our dialect, in our local content. Now, you're putting up an accent like a Will Smith out there can never beat a Will Smith in his territory.
I get.
So we need to get ourselves together and stop being fake. Thinking that's the way to, I'm flying, I'm on the right carpet. Oh, the movie is fantastic. Oh my God, fantastic color, beautiful, whatever. Beyond that, how does the man make his money home?
Okay.
I'm a businessman. I'm a realist. I'm not here talking about what I don't know. So the Nigerian people need to put themselves back and begin to make movies that really represent Nigerian cultures and our lifestyle. When somebody is crying in Nigeria, that is where there are ways we cry. You know, when they say in Igbo, sorry, Ibakwa is different from Ikenpo. When you're if in Kenpo, it's like, then when you're crying, it's normal crying. Now, when a Nigerian wants to Ikenpo, it's a different way. You understand that? Now, if you're Ikenpo, you're supposed to be like, you're like, oh, duh, I'm just crying, you know. You're not touching the character.
I get.
So we should stop being fake. I don't want to be an American. Hello?
Hi.
I'm an Igbo man.
Oh.
And I'll never be an American.
I'll
only be a Nigerian. So let's represent what we stand for. And that's what the world wants to buy. So that takes us to the next level. We need to tell our stories properly, the way we are as Nigerians. Go to do a lot of research and then stop being fake. Stop putting up fake accents. Stop trying to look like a white man. All we need are the technical, you know hows. Get more better equipment. Get trainings. And that's all we need right now.
Thank you so much, Emeka Ike. It was, really, it just feels like the minutes are not enough because there's still so much to talk about. Well, thank you very much.
Thanks, Toke.
So that was a wonderful time with Emeka Ike. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. We have loads and loads of other things to bring you away.
Such a wealth of experience and still much more to know about this great industry and its players. It's time now to see the interesting movies to watch this week.
Interesting movies to watch this week are The Department.
Have you come to join us? Why didn't you shoot him? Not another step!
Will you please? I'm calling that in my bed!
An assault is the only way.
The assault goes ahead of the plan.
Birthday bash.
My father is a pastor.
Correct.
You see, rubbish collect all the things.
Dingala. As a man, collect everything.
Everything our own, yeah.
Stand down. Stand down.
Only one option here. If we smuggle ourselves through this window here.
Let us kill this thing.
Look, do you have a back door or something?
The program is still Nigerian Movies Today on the network service of NTA. Nigerians outside the shores of the country are known to excel in the movie world. In this segment, you get to know some of them and appreciate this great country. Nigerian stars in the diaspora beckons.
On Nigerian stars in diaspora this week are Searchlight Beams on Nikki Amuka Bird. a Nigerian-born English actress born in Delta State, Nigeria, on the 27th of February 1976. Nikki left Delta State as a young child to live with her mother in the UK. Her intentions of being a dancer was thwarted by injury of the back. This led her to where destiny certainly awaits her. Nikki went into drama college, where she fell in love with acting. She then went to Lambda and subsequently performed for the first time. Her theatrical credits include Welcome to Thebes, Twelfth Night, for which she won an Ian Charson Award nomination in 2004, World Music, Top Girls by Oxford Stage Company, A Midsummer Night's Dream, The Tempest and the Servant of Two Masters by Royal Shakespeare Company. Nikki's film credits include The Omen, a 2006 remake, Cargo, Almost Heaven, as well as a screen adaptation of Alexander McCall Smith's novel, The Number One Ladies Detective Agency on television. She has appeared in Spooks, The Line of Beauty, The Last Enemy, Robin Hood, Touchwood, and a recurring role in the BBC apocalyptic series Survivors. She also appeared in the BBC adaptation of Andra Levy's award-winning novel Small Island, broadcast in December 2009. She is married to actor Jeffrey Streatfeild.
Nigerians are indeed good people, and of course a great nation. With so much happening on daily basis in the Nigerian motion picture industry, let's take Nollywood moment.
When HIV and AIDS became a reality, the mode of getting infected and stigmatization was a major issue, especially in Nigeria and Africa at large. However, so much had been done by different organizations through jingles, seminars, films, and different forums. As these efforts continue, a movie was premiered during the week about stigmatization, denial, and cultural pride of people living with HIV and AIDS and those who have been able to overcome. The movie is titled Stigma, with the caption, "Let them hate, so long as we fight stigmatization." The movie is produced and directed by Dagogo Daminas and cast Jackie Appiah, Emeka Ike, Hilda Dukubo, Ngozi Nwosu, and other Nollywood bigwigs.
Stigma, it's a story about a mother and a daughter who contracted HIV/AIDS from the kind of job they do as a traditional bed attendant. The mother could not stand the stigma as regards the community, so she died. But the daughter, she fought stigma and triumphed over death. So it's about the triumph over death.
During the week, Honorable Desmond Olusola Elliott received certificate of return into the Lagos State Legislative Chamber. Lagos State INEC Resident Electoral Commissioner Akin Orebiyi advised the legislators to uphold the electoral campaign promises by working together for the common good of the people.
I'm a very fast learner and I'm going through certain trainings and stuff, but I have within my head issues that need to be talked about, dealt with, discussed, and those are what things I'll be carrying along with me.
Guests, celebrities, and government functionaries turn en masse to witness as Newman Street Season 2 premiered in Lagos at the weekend. If you watched Season 1 of the exciting series, you will be thrilled to want to see what Season 2 has in store for you. This interesting series features East Nollywood heavyweights like Hafiz Oyetoro, popularly called Saka, Bimbo Akintola, Fred Amata, Shafi Bello Akimisi, Sunny Danja, with special guest appearances by Two-Face Idibia.
I mean, Newman Street is a program, a platform, where as organic as it can get, it allows other products to also replicate. So for instance, today we're not just launching Newman Street, we're also launching a national malaria theme song. And the characters that sang the song are also characters on Newman Street. And if you remember the slogan of Newman Street, it's life as it is. So it's life as it is as a Nigerian, life as it is in the community, life as it is, irrespective of where you live, irrespective of what your social status is. It's the challenges that you and I face, I mean, as men and women, as family men, aspiring people, trying to progress your career, trying to do so many things.
It's been quite unbelievable. It's been tasking. Season 2 offers like 400 members of cast. We worked with the biggest musical artists on the continent. We worked with Two-Face. We worked with Righteous Man. We introduced Saka. We introduced a bit of Norbert Young. And it was wonderful. It was difficult for us to manage and shuffle everybody's itinerary to fit into the schedule, but we did.
The present season 1 has been beautiful, wonderful, and I think this season 2 is going to make a lot of difference. Like malaria, though treatable, preventable, curable, yes, is still responsible for the killings of several children. And I think there are two dimensions to things, the religious way and the entertainment way. You know, sometimes people tend to believe on some issue religiously. But again, you can captivate a lot of people through the entertainment. And I think this one is going to make a lot of impact because it has a huge followership.
Just like yesterday, it's a year that Nigerian motion pictures practitioners, family and friends lost a prolific award-winning filmmaker and broadcast executive, Uzuamaka Audrey Igwe, popularly called Amaka Igwe, to the cold hands of death. Remembering Amaka Igwe, her daughter Ruby Igwe took to her Facebook page to share a touching and emotional tribute 1 year after. Dear mommy, it's been 1 year today since you moved house, moved home, exchange earth for eternity. No forwarding address that I can visit and come back from. No quit notice. No forewarning. No explanation. You vanished. I first thought that, like in Scandals and Hawaii 5-0, you weren't really gone. I dreamt about your comeback. I borrowed all the scenarios from every action movie. It was going to be epic. I imagined the explanations, the super security types, the massive conspiracy that you had to thwart. How sorry not sorry you would be because you had to do what you had to do. I prepared how long I would be angry for, but you didn't show up. So far, no comeback. You keep doing you in heaven. I will see you when I see you. I love you, I love you, I love you until forever. Ruby Igwe, the sixth term lawyer and barrister to be.
Encouraged by your comments, mails, and suggestions, we say thank you for keeping them coming, as you can reach us on www.facebook.com/movies today.nta, Twitter at NTA Movies Today, email NTA Nigerian Movies Today at gmail.com, or SMS, please just SMS. 08056314586. This is where we draw the curtain on this week's show. Believing your time with us has been worth the while. Thanking you for being part of this week's episode. Let's do this again next time, next week, and be proudly Nigerian.